Reservation for the Williams.
Oh yes, the honeymoon suite. It's all ready. Your luggage came earlier and it took them up. Will you please sign this for me?
Thank you.
Good afternoon, Lisa Hotel Northridge. I may help you. Please hold. Thank you. She'll send it to you, please.
Thank you very much. Hello? Hello? Yes, Pete? What a pleasant surprise. When are you coming home?
Not just yet, Bajo. But soon. I want to spend some time over here with some friends. Hey guys, I have some good news. A big matter with you.
Okay, Pete, we are here. What is this good news you want to tell us? Have you found yourself a girlfriend?
Much better than that.
What?
Joe, what is it?
No, Pete. No.
Joe, speak to me. Hello? Hello, Pete, what is it? What did you tell Pa Joe? What?
Bastard hasn't changed one bit. Still as selfish as I remembered him.
Now, what was all that about?
It's nothing really. It's just a bad memory, that's all.
Sandra. What are you talking about? You went completely kinetic on me. Look at your face. It's as if you've seen a ghost. Please don't tell me it's nothing.
It's just a bad experience I had with that man, Joe Evans.
Are you talking of the Joe Evans of Williamson Holdings?
That very one, the bastard.
No, you can't be serious. That epitome of a gentleman. Oh.
Damn! My knees are already hurting. How would I want to drop a key now? Hey, Joe. What are you doing down there on your hands and knees? Why, have you become one of those born-again preachers who praise just everywhere?
Oh, shut up, you fool!
Don't you see I'm picking my keys?
And what's wrong with being born again anyway?
Nothing. Nothing. You're going to hell, right?
How do you know?
Oh, please. Give me a little credit. You have been going to the barber every 2 weeks for almost 20 years. Religiously on a Thursday. You have never missed a date. The whole town knows about this.
Hey, Gloria!
You cannot find a more caring, trusting, and a more honest person than that man, Joe Evans. It would take me a lot to convince him.
Duke! You never miss your chance with the ladies. Anyway, you're not correct. Of course I've missed some dates. What about those 3 months I spent in Jamaica on the sugarcane plantation?
How could I forget? That's right, of course. That was when you came back with your locks, huh? Looking like a cross between Bob Marley and Lauryn Hill. That was 5 years ago, is that right? Oh gosh, how time flies.
But even with your locks, you still go to the barber. Don't let this hair fool you, you know. In as much as you see it like this, it still needs constant care and attention. And secondly, since Annie is the best, why go anywhere else?
Of course, of course. Okay, right, tell Annie I'll be in later. I have a launching date, you know.
Okay, Dookie!
Finish up some flowers. Okay. Sure. Why not?
Thank you.
Yes, madam.
Hey, girlfriend, slow down. Remember, you're driving us home.
Don't worry, sweetheart. I can down 10 of this and still take you home.
Sandra, I know that. All our friends know that. I guess your parents may even know that. But you see, when that cop stops us and asks you to blow into that little bag, he doesn't know that.
Oh, come on, baby. You worry too much.
Hi, Joe.
Hey. I'll be with you in a moment.
Alright. Joe, come over.
Hey, why this long face, old boy? Isn't it today that Peter comes home with his new bride?
You're right. And I want to look extra special. First impressions count, you know?
That's very true. But no matter what I do, you will still have to do something about this long face of yours.
You would have a long face too if you were in my shoes.
Tell me something, Joe. Did you think Peter was going to get married so soon after university?
I had no idea at all until I received that phone call 3 weeks ago.
Don't you think that is the death of his parents that is causing this untypical behavior?
My problem is this. Peter is a nice boy, but very naive. He's very trusting and thinks no evil of anyone.
You can't fault him on that, you know. That's a beautiful way to live, even though I couldn't do it. I am the typical Old Testament eye for an eye character.
You know that Peter doesn't know how much he's worth.
Now, Joe, tell me you are kidding. You mean Peter, at 29, doesn't know how rich he is? Oh, someone pinch me. This is a dream, isn't it?
He's quite happy to let me run things the way his father had suggested in the will. He only just wanted to finish university.
Well, I understand. It's just an incredible story.
He'll be home in a few hours' time with a new bride. Someone I have never met No family background, nothing.
Huh?
I'll be meeting her for the first time today.
You don't think he would have sent one of those pre-something-something?
Prenuptial agreements.
That's right.
I hope to God he did. But knowing Peter as I do, I doubt it.
Oh, Joe, I'm now beginning to understand your problem. Cheer up, old boy.
Now tell me, what is this terrible thing Mr. Evans is supposed to have done to you?
You know, I worked with the Williamson Holdings before, right?
Mm-hmm. It was late one night. We had just finished a board meeting.
And when is that damn fax from South America coming in? Oh, it's been a long day and I'm so tired. All I want to do is go soak his knees in a hot tub.
Let me check again. Maybe it has come. Why the hell did I drink so much wine? I can hardly control myself. Tonight is going to be one hell of a night.
Sandra, what the hell do you think you're doing? Will you leave my office this minute? Now go and put your clothes back on. What on earth is wrong with you, girl?
What is wrong, Mr. Evans? Don't you find me attractive?
That's not the point, Sandra. You're young enough to be my daughter. Secondly, I never get involved with my staff. Now, please, leave this office and go and put your clothes back on before someone walks into this room. Go!
Oh my God. What have I done?
Sandra! What the fuck made you do something like that?
Call it desperation if you will. I sat and looked at his handsome face, and I flipped. What kind of a man is he? To reject me, Sandra. To reject a body like this. Can you imagine? He must be crazy.
You know, let's get out of here and hit the shops. The bill, please. We can continue this conversation at home.
What's wrong with you? Is someone chasing you?
You know Helen in the supermarket. I've always had to hide from her.
I thought you broke up with her some time ago.
That woman is bent on getting me into serious trouble. Remember when my wife went to visit her sister for 2 weeks?
Yes, yes. I remember very well. And during that time, you behaved like a tomcat.
I picked her one day from work. It was raining. And I made the biggest mistake of my life. I slept over and now...
What?
I can't get rid of her.
Why? Wasn't she any good?
You are kidding. She is fantastic. But I just found out that her current boyfriend is that cop we call Rambo.
Duke! You mean you are messing with Rambo's girlfriend?
Rambo, can you imagine that? And now he's found out that I'm messing with his woman.
Lord have mercy on you.
When I found out, I told her that we had to stop since I did not want any more trouble. But instead of this bitch leaving me alone, she tries to get me into bed anytime she sees me.
Hey, Duke, maybe it's you they should call Rambo.
Bajo, what kept you so long? You are late for lunch.
I bet you were in that barber shop with all those stupid old men who have nothing else to do but talk rubbish all day.
Calm down. It's only 2 o'clock.
We need 1 hour to get to the airport. So calm down and tell me what's for lunch.
I'm so sorry, Joe. I'm just anxious. I did a nice chicken and mushroom omelette for you.
There's lemonade in the fridge or anything else you would like?
What about a nice glass of white wine?
Joyce, Pajo's lunch, please. Something bothering you.
I've known you for long and I can read you like a book.
Don't worry, Martha. Everything's under
control. Oh, like hell it is. Since that telephone call from Master Pete, you haven't been yourself. And I can't blame you. Why did he have to run off and get married like that?
Your guess is as good as mine. I guess I just have to wait until he comes to find out. Anyway, have the glass of wine.
To better times. Joe, don't worry. Everything will be alright. I know Peter. I'm sure he knows what he's doing.
Martha, you know me too well. I must admit, there's some logic in what you just said. Now, please have this glass of wine with me.
Oh, all right. But you see, I have so much to do, I can't go messing up my head.
When did one glass of wine start messing your head up? Remember, I know you too. Anyway, Martha, what did you prepare for the newlyweds? Knowing you, really sumptuous.
I think I outdid myself this time. I did pot roast beef served with potatoes, cooked in gravy, green beans and carrots.
Sounds good. And for afters?
Oh, fresh fruit salad and vanilla ice cream.
That sounds great. However, since we don't know what Peter's bride likes, I suggest you prepare fish and chicken dish.
Oh dear, I think you are right. I wonder how that slipped me. I better get started. Joyce, remove the fish fillet and chicken breast from the freezer and thaw them as quickly as possible.
Did you make all the changes I suggested?
Mm-hmm.
Martha, is that all you're going to say? Mm-hmm. Do you realize that history is about to take place in this house today?
Oh, may God help us. Anyway, I think you like what you see. Shall we go and have a look?
Oh,
matter. What a transformation. The floral arrangement, the color combination. Beautiful. Just beautiful.
Damn. Damn. That man can still ignite a fire in me. Memories, Martha. That is all they can be. Memories. But it wouldn't be from lack of trying, Joe. It was all up to you. One thing that's for sure. I will love you until the day I die.
Martha, I'm leaving now.
Okay, Joe, be careful.
Hey, Sam. The Lexus is gleaming a little bit extra today.
Yes, I have to make a very good impression. Ajo,
are you ready?
What is it?
No, Pete. No.
Joe, speak to me.
I'll be meeting her for the first time today.
You don't think he would have signed one of those pre-something-something?
Prenuptial agreements.
That's right.
I hope to God he did.
I sat and looked at his handsome face and I flipped.
What is wrong, Mr. Evans? Don't you find me out?
That's not the point, Sandra. You're young enough to be my daughter. Secondly, I never get involved with my staff. Oh, Martha, what a transformation! The floral arrangement, the color combination. Beautiful. Just beautiful.
Damn. Damn. That man can still ignite a fire in me.